One biggest lesson we learn as federation is that you can't provide everything, and you can't provide even a single thing. What you can do is we can engage in the provision of everything from the single thing. What I would like for federation to take forward in the next 21 and years to come is to strengthen co-production partnership, because this is the only way. We have a lot of resources in our national exchequer. These resources are generated in terms of our tax, and when we leave them to be spent in a concise knowledge of the few that we call the government officials, then we are really selling ourselves out. We need to engage with the government to leverage, to mobilize these resources, to position the poor, the people, not even the poor, to position the people to engage with the government so that they can be able to prioritize and champion what kind of development they need that can change their daily life. Because our Kenya government has embarked on mega projects. But I wonder how this mega project impact the regional people's life. This is just because of the regional unblocking, the regional opening. I don't believe the link between Kenya and Uganda can provide a meal on the table of a poor person who has a leaking roof on the head. I don't believe the mega road, the standard gauge rail line, can translate to anything to the poor people in the informal settlement. I want to see the government taking priority in terms of providing housing incentives, providing city funds where people can engage directly and participate like owners of the nation, and taking their priority forward to demand that their resources deserves their decisions. So the federation has the capacity in terms of numbers, in terms of strategies, in terms of experience, in terms of exposures, to take forward the issue of strengthening co-production. Co-production in terms of the government and the people and their leader, their own leadership, and the people within their own setups. And I believe it's only even in the federation set up strongholds that we didn't find like emergence of post-election violence, because we have been managing to see each other. Like, we could even call each other, how are you doing? How is Nani? He's always with you in the same settlement. He's safe. So you see, like, if the government can embrace the attitude and the aspiration and the strategies of the federation, the federation is the best citizen the government should engage with. The role of the county where government is more or less the same as the role of the national government. Mm-hmm. It's more or less the role of the national government, because it's just about a decentralized responsibility and mm-hmm. powers and resources. Mm-hmm. Whatever happens in the national government are the voices that have been being seen at the county government. It means that what county government is doing is what the national government supplements. Okay. So we're still operating the same system of the government. So the county government responsibility, key and primary responsibility, one, and I will say it, develop people's participation policy, where people can be able, where it can be guided by the principle of law, that this is a demand. And participation should not be symbolic. It should be real and inclusive. So any county government that develops people's participation policy is a government of the people. But any government who doesn't have any participation policy, it simply means they're still operating in the hierarchy of leadership, whereby there's a section that knows, section that need to know, and in between there's knowledge that nobody wants to share. So the county government has a lot to do in terms of streamlining the gap between the government and the people, and even the people who are poor and the rich. One issue about Kisumu I always pray for very much is proper inclusive urban planning. If you have that, Federation will have a very enabling environment to invest. The international community will have an enabling environment to invest. The poor people will have the zeal to save, to change their life. If you have proper planning, that is not going to be disrupted by spatial plannings that are destructive to properties, destructive to efforts.